Good morning everyone, welcome to Narayana online video classes. Today for class 8 students we are going to study trigonometric identities. Okay, what are the trigonometric identities we have and how to obtain them and what are the applications of those identities, that is what we are going to study under this class. Now there are three very important identities in trigonometry which are very useful in solving good number of problems while in the due course. Now what are they? The first identity is sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. What is theta here? Theta is any real number. Theta can be any real number in such a way sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. That's what we have to prove. Now let us see its proof. For the proof sake, let me take a right triangle ABC. Okay, angle, let's see, let me take it as theta. Now let us define in triangle ABC angle B is equal to 90 degrees. As it is 90 degrees, it obtains the properties of a right triangle. So we can say sine theta is equal to, sine theta is nothing but the ratio to opposite side and hypotenuse, that is AB upon AC. What about cos theta? Cos theta is adjacent side to theta by hypotenuse, that is BC. Now let us take the LHS part of this. What is LHS part of this? Sin square theta plus cos square theta. That is going to be sin square theta is AB by AC whole square plus BC by AC whole square, that is cos square, cos theta whole square value. Now that is otherwise AB square by AC square plus BC square by AC square. If you look at that, both have the same denominator. So AC square is LCM for that. Then we can have AB square plus BC square as numerator part. Now as it is a right triangle, according to Pythagoras theorem, square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of other two sides. So we can say that is equal to AC square by AC square. So what is AC square by AC square is 1. So by taking a right triangle and defining sin theta cos theta, then LHS part sin square theta plus cos square theta, then if you simplify further by applying Pythagoras theorem, of course we could able to obtain the result as 1. So the identity is proved. That is sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Okay, therefore now I can say sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Here there is no restriction on theta. Theta can be any real number, because for any theta, sin theta is defined as well as cos theta is defined. Sin 0 degrees is defined, cos 0 degrees is defined. Sin 90 degrees is defined, cos 90 degrees is defined. It is any angle for any theta belongs to R. Both are defined values. So certainly sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1 for same theta. Remember, theta, whatever theta you have, the same theta must be here, then only the identity holds good. If it is sin square 30 degrees, it is also cos square 30 degrees. You should not take another theta. That is very important. So for the same theta, which is any real number, sin square theta plus cos square theta is always 1. Now this is the actual identity. There are certain sub identities based on this. Means some important formula we can obtain using this identity. What are they? Let us see. They are, the first one, sin square theta is 1 minus cos square theta. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So that sin square theta is 1 minus cos square theta. Then what about sin theta? That is plus or minus under root 1 minus cos square theta. It can be either plus or minus depending on the quadrant in which theta lies. The result will be either plus or minus. Based on sign of trigonometric ratios, we can decide whether it is plus or minus if once you know theta value, right? Now if you take cos square theta, cos square theta is 1 minus sin square theta. Okay, then what is cos theta? That is plus or minus under root 1 minus sin square theta. Okay, using the given identity, these are the sub rules, sub identities, or certain important formula we can derive
this in this form also we use the results in solving certain problems. Okay, so it is better to remember all these results. Throughout trigonometry, we mostly use these identities. So it's always suggestible for remembering these all results as formulae. Right? Now we'll move to the next identity.
Identity two. The second identity is secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1.
Secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1. Let us see how we obtain that.
Proof, let us see. We have using right angle here we can prove, or using the first identity also we can prove this. Okay. Now let us take the first identity. What is that? Sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1.
So you need secant square and tan square here. Secant square and tan square. So let us divide both the sides with cos square theta. On dividing both the sides with cos square theta, what do you have now?
That implies sin square theta by cos square theta plus cos square theta by cos square theta, that is equal to 1 by cos square theta. That implies sin square theta by cos square theta is tan square theta plus this is 1 is equal to secant square theta. If you simplify further, it will be secant square theta minus tan square theta, that is equal to 1.
Here I must specify one very important condition,
that is it is not true for any theta, for every theta. Why? Because secant theta and tan theta are not defined if theta is, because secant theta is 1 by cos theta, it is a 1 by cos theta, cos is in denominator. If cos theta is 0, there secant is not defined. So where cos is 0? Cos is 0 at 90 degrees, cos 90 degrees is 0. Not only at 90 degrees, for all odd integral multiples of 90, like cos 270 degrees, cos 450 degrees, all odd integral multiples of 90 degrees, cos is 0. So, whenever you are taking theta, we should exclude those odd integral multiples of pi by 2, okay, for the consideration, because they won't give you the result secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1 value. So we have to write theta belongs to r minus 2n plus 1 times pi by 2, where n belongs to z. All real numbers except 2n plus 1 times of pi by 2 n belongs to z. The values, okay, which gives you cos theta 0 are to be excluded. That is very, very important point here. So whenever you are studying secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1, this is how we have to prove it. Now even for this we have certain sub identities, or if you say some another important formula, those can be derived using this identity. What are they? We'll see. The thing is secant square theta is 1 plus tan square theta, then secant theta is root over 1 plus tan square theta.
Okay, as usual, plus or minus.
Next, we have tan square theta as secant square theta minus 1, and tan theta as plus or minus root over secant square theta minus 1.
Okay, in addition to this formula, we have few more formula for this identity.
What are they? We have secant square theta minus tan square theta 1. That is going to be secant theta plus tan theta times secant theta minus tan theta is 1. That implies secant theta plus tan theta will be equivalent to 1 by secant theta minus tan. This is one rule. Similarly, secant theta minus tan theta will be 1 by secant theta plus tan theta. This is another rule. These two another
important formula we get in addition to this formula, okay, because it is in the form of a square minus b square. A plus b into a minus b is 1, so we can write secant theta plus tan theta is 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Similarly, secant theta minus tan theta is 1 by secant theta plus tan theta. Okay, so these are certain important results which you have to remember based on this particular identity. Okay, now we'll move to the third identity. The third identity is
secant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1.
Okay, here also very important thing, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta, cosecant is 1 by sine, sine is in denominator position. So whenever sine is in denominator position, sine theta is in denominator position, sine theta should not be 0, such theta should be excluded. Okay, so where sine theta is 0, sine theta is 0 at theta 0 degrees, theta pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, minus pi, minus 2 pi. So what do you say? All multiples of, integral multiples of pi, n pi I can say, sine n pi is always 0. So those n pi values are to be excluded for defining this particular identity. So what you say now?
Theta is belongs to all real numbers except n pi, where n belongs to z.
Where n is a integer. So all multiples of pi, integral multiples of pi are to be excluded. Okay, then only these two are defined, so the identity holds good. This is very important point. For sine square theta plus cos square theta, we have taken theta is equal to 1 for the first identity. Theta belongs to R, we have considered, because there is no restriction for theta. Second identity, secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1. We have restricted theta to R minus 2n plus 1 times pi by 2. Those are not correct. Okay, those are not valid. Next, if you take the third identity, cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is 1, we are considering theta as R minus n pi, where n is an integral multiple of integral multiple. Okay, so because for those values, these two are not defined, so that we have to exclude them. These are three very important points. Next, we'll see its proof.
We have sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1, that is first identity. Now, in earlier case, we have divided with cos square theta. Now we divide it with sine square theta. If you divide with sine square theta, on dividing both the sides with sine square theta. So what do you have? Sine square theta by sine square theta 1 plus cot square theta is equal to 1 by sine square theta, that is cosecant square theta. That implies cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is of course 1.
Okay, now even for this we have certain sub-identities, some important rules. Let us see what are they.
The first one is cosecant square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. Next, so cosecant theta will be plus or minus under root of 1 plus cot square theta. Next, cot square theta is cosecant square theta minus 1. Then cot theta is plus or minus under root of cosecant square theta minus 1. In addition to this, we have cosecant theta plus cot theta is equal to 1 by cosecant theta minus cot theta.
Just like secant theta plus tan theta, 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Okay.
Similarly, cosecant theta minus cot theta is 1 by cosecant theta plus cot theta.
These are the very important deductions from this particular identity, which are very useful in solving the problems. Okay. Now we'll move to few problems. Okay. Now we'll see. The first problem is,
if secant theta is equal to m plus n by 2 root mn, find sine theta.
Okay, so here as secant theta is given, that secant theta we have to convert into cos. Once you know cos theta, based on the identity, the first identity, we can find out sine theta value, right? Let us see that. Now,
given secant theta is equal to m plus n by 2 root m, that implies cos theta is equal to, what is cos theta? Reciprocal of secant theta. So we can say it as 2 root mn by m plus n. Now we have cos theta, then how to find out sine theta? We have sine theta is plus or minus under root 1 minus cos square theta. That is otherwise plus or minus under root 1 minus 2 root mn by m plus n. person whole square. If you simplify further, it is going to be plus r minus root over here m plus n whole square will be LCM. So we have m plus n whole square minus 4mn. If you further simplify this, m plus n whole square minus 4mn, it is like a plus b whole square minus 4ab, that is a minus b whole square. So that is going to be plus r minus root over m minus n whole square by m plus n whole square. That is otherwise plus r minus m minus n by m plus n. That is the value of sin theta. Depending on theta value, if m is more than n or m is less than n, where theta lies, if at all you know, you can clearly define whether it is plus of minus n by m plus n or minus of m minus n by m plus n. But time being, if you don't know what is theta, we can simply write it as plus or minus m minus n upon m plus n. That is the value of sin theta. So here we are using identity, sin square theta plus cos square theta 1. Based on that, we have proved certain results. One of the results we are using in proving this. Okay, now we will move to the next problem. The problem is, if secant theta plus tan theta is equal to p, then find the value of sin theta in terms of p. We are given secant theta plus tan theta as p, so he is asking us to find out the value of sin theta in terms of p. The answer must be in terms of p. Solution: secant theta plus tan theta is p. Okay, let us consider it as condition number one. Then can I say secant theta minus tan theta is 1 by p? While studying the second identity, secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1, we have proved certain results in that. One of the results is this: secant theta minus tan theta is 1 by secant theta plus tan theta, so that is 1 by p. Now, if you do 1 plus 1, on adding 1 into 1 plus 2 implies, equations 1 and 2, let us add up, we have secant theta plus tan theta is p, secant theta minus tan theta is 1 by p. If you add up these two, you have 2 secant theta as p plus 1 by p, okay, or secant theta is, or let us write it like p square plus 1 by p. Let us take it as condition number 3. Similarly, let us subtract these two, 1 minus 2 implies, then we have secant theta plus tan theta is p, secant theta minus tan theta is 1 by p. If I subtract here, signs will change. So I have secant theta cancel this time. So we have 2 tan theta is, I can directly write, it is p minus 1 by p or p square minus 1 by p. That is 2 tan theta. Let me take it as condition number 4. Now what do you need now? You need sin theta. How will you get sin theta? Tan theta if you have, tan theta is sin theta by cos theta. By secant theta if you take, that is by 1 by cos theta cancels and remain with sin theta. Okay, now for that sake, we divide the fourth condition with third condition. Let us see that. Fourth condition by third condition implies that is 2 tan theta is equal to p square minus 1 upon p, here by 2 secant theta, here it is p square plus 1 by p. To cancels, tan theta is sin theta by cos theta and 1 by cos theta, so simply it is sin theta, that is going to be p square minus 1 upon p square plus 1. This is how we got the value of sin theta in terms of p. Okay, so throughout if you look at, we are using the identity secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1, its results in proving this particular question. Okay, that's how we can solve the problems. We see the rest of the problems tomorrow. Bye.